In this video lecture, we're going to take a look at a handful of standard application patterns which all make use of the while loop. Okay, let's get started. Looping, and currently for us while looping, is a component you'll see over and over again in many common programming applications. It's so common, in fact, that standard programming boilerplate patterns exist for many examples such as the following: accumulation, or the summing up of many numbers; counting, the tallying of many numbers; averaging, which simply involves a combination of accumulation and counting; finding minimum or maximum values; and animation, which unfortunately we won't get to cover in this course. In the following examples, we'll take a look at the first four of the standard application patterns. In each case, we'll lay out the standard pseudocode for that example, and then point you to some source code example for more details. Take some time to go through the cited source code and walkthrough videos, because they will give you lots of useful specific code examples. The first standard looping application we'd like to consider is accumulation. Here, the objective is simply to sum up the total of some unknown quantity of numbers. So here on the right is the pseudocode for doing that. First, we initialize some running total to zero, because if we don't do this first, we'll get a wrong answer. We also set up some sentinel value to check against. Then, we read the first number in the series, which serves as our priming read. We check that first number against the sentinel value and enter the while loop. As long as the number is not equal to the sentinel value, which is our loop continuation condition here, we add that number to the running total, and here we are using the arithmetic shortcut operator to do that. Then we read the next number and then repeat the process over and over again until we encounter the sentinel value, and then our total is complete because there are no more values to be read. By the way, we need to be sure that we declare that total variable outside this while loop if we want to do something with it outside the loop here. To see a short example of accumulation, please take a moment to pause this video and view the short code walkthrough video for looping-while-accumulation.java, which you'll find in the usual place. Open up this file in JGrasp so you can follow along, then come back to this video when you are finished. The next standard looping application we'll consider is counting. The objective now is to simply tally up the number of items read in. So here again on the right is the pseudocode for doing that. Again, we start by initializing our count to zero, otherwise we'll get a wrong answer. And as before, we also set up some sentinel value to check against. Then once again, we read the first number in the series, which again is our priming read. Then we check that first number against the sentinel value, and enter the while loop. As before, as long as the number is not equal to the sentinel value, which again is our loop continuation condition, we increment our count by 1. Optionally, if we choose to do so, we might make this contingent upon the number first passing some test. For example, maybe we want to also check that the number is greater than 0 or something like that before incrementing this count. Then as before, we read the next number and repeat this loop body over and over again until we finally encounter the sentinel value. At that point, we have no more numbers to count, our loop is finished, and presumably we do something with that final count. Again, note that we have to declare this count outside and before this loop if we want to do something with it outside the loop. To see a short example of counting, please take a moment to pause this video and view the short code walkthrough video for loop-while-counting.java, which you'll find in the usual place. Open up this file in JGrasp so you can follow along, then come back to this video when you are finished. The next standard looping application to be considered is averaging. This one is simply a mashup of both accumulation and counting, performing both tasks within the same application. So here on the right is the pseudocode for averaging. This time, we need to set up both a total and a count and initialize their values to zero, lest we come up with a wrong answer. We again set up a sentinel value to know when we're done reading valid data. Then we read in our first number as a priming read, check it against the sentinel value, and enter the while loop. This time we perform two operations. We update the total and we increment the count by 1. As always, we read the next number as an update read, then return to the top of the loop to check the loop continuation condition with that new number. As long as it is not equal to the sentinel value, we repeat this loop over and over again until we do read in the sentinel value, at which point our reading of data is complete. Following the loop, we perform the usual averaging calculation using the final values for total and count. In this example, we're assuming that our numbers are all ints, therefore their total is also an int, as is their count, so normally we would be performing an integer division here. But to get the desired decimal precision for the average, remember the idea of mixed types and casting. So we explicitly cast one of the values up to a double, which then results in a floating point division, which gives us the desired decimal precision for average. This is just like an earlier program problem you may have done involving a batting average or a temperature conversion or something similar. If we want to be extra cautious, we might also guard against the case where we haven't read any numbers and the count is zero, so as to guard against division by zero, but that's not considered here. To see a short example of averaging, please take a moment to pause this video and view the short code walkthrough video for loopingwhileaveraging.java, which you'll find in the usual place. Open up this file in JGrasp so you can follow along, then come back to this video when you are finished. Finally, the last standard looping application we'll consider is finding the minimum or maximum of some unknown quantity of numbers. Here we're showing the pseudocode for finding the minimum, but of course the approach for finding the maximum will be similar. We need to again establish a sentinel value, but this time we need to be a little careful with that and select a sentinel value that is clearly not any valid data. For example, maybe the usual -1 could now be a real value, so maybe -999 would be a better choice here. What we do now is read the first number in a priming read, then set the initial minimum value to that first number. Note that in this case we do not set the minimum to 0 or any other arbitrary constant, because we could have the case of every number we read being greater than that arbitrary constant, which would incorrectly fix the result to that constant. So as before, we enter the loop, and as long as the number we read is not equal to the sentinel value, we keep executing this loop. Now on each iteration, we check if the number is less than the current minimum, and if it is, we reset the minimum value down to that current number. We then read the next number, return to check the loop continuation condition, and make another pass through the loop. We continue looping over and over until the number is equal to the sentinel value, at which point there are no more numbers to be read and we are done with this loop. We then do something with this minimum value, perhaps print it or something, and then we are done. As we said, finding the maximum would be very similar. In that case, we would set the maximum to our first value, then inside the loop, check whether the number was now greater than the maximum, in which case we'd reset the maximum value up to the current number. Apart from that, this algorithm is the same for finding minimum or maximum values. To wrap things up, to see a short example of finding a minimum, please now view the short code walkthrough video for loopingwhileminimum.java, which you'll find in the usual place. Open up this file in JGrasp so you can follow along. But otherwise, that concludes this discussion of standard while looping applications.